Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today I'm here with the first throwback favorites for this year. First I was like, okay, I'm going to do a throwback favorite for each and every month, but then I was like, no. But in March last year I found a lot of new super favorites and that I still have as favorites, so I think it was going so I thought it was going to be fun to do this a throwback of March. I don't know what's up with my ability to speak, it's like gone. So we can start with two skincare products, but one of them I have here and the other one I have found. I talk more about it when we come into that. So, okay, one of the things is this Jade Roller. This was like super popular a year ago. And this I use when I have put on like my serum sometimes and I roll it into the skin. I don't know if it helps, but it feels really, really good. And also one thing I love to use it with right now is put on a sheet mask and then like roll the sheet mask closer to the skin. I love that. So this I still really, really like. I don't know if it does anything, but it feels really good. And if my skin is like a little bit irritated or something, I like to roll this. And this is super nice to have around my eyes. So I still really like this. I don't use it that often anymore, but I really, really like it. The other skincare product I talked about was the Milky Mist from Pixi. I still love that Milky Mist. It is, though, pretty expensive and it's not that much in the bottle, so it, like, runs out so fast. So I have tried some other mists, and the Milky Mist from Pixi is still my favorite, but a close second is this one from Body Shop. So I thought I was going to talk about this in this video. So this is the Vitamin E Hydration Face Mist, and I really like this. I usually take this. I sometimes use it in the mornings, sometimes at night, and I take this before, after my toner, and then I take this, or I take it when I feel dry, like during the day or something, but I really like this, and I think this is a good, if you don't want to spend the money on the Pixi, and yeah, this is really good, and I think this is vegan as well. I'm not sure, but I really like this and I think this is really, really good. Then if we go into the skincare, Then if we go into the makeup, I talked about the concealer that I use to highlight my face with, and it is the Revolution Conceal and Correct in White. I still like to highlight with this, but I don't do it. I don't have that much cover in my foundation. Maybe in this foundation I have on now. But in my serum foundation, it's not that much coverage. And I don't like to use it with this. So I still use it sometimes to highlight, but I don't love it that much. I don't think I need it right now, if I'm going to be honest. So I still like it, and if you are pale and want something to highlight, I still have a hard time to find really light concealers that I can highlight with, so this is really good. And then I also talked about another mist, and I can't believe that I've had this for a year, but it is the H2 Glow Mist from Linda Hallberg. I still haven't used it up because I only use this in special occasions. But I think it only should be open for 12 months, so I should use it up. But I really like this one. It gives an amazing glow, and I love to have this when I have used a powder foundation and like only that, and have done like a highlighter and a blush and then take this, because it looks so good. And it is a really good mist, but it is pretty expensive. The bottle is really, really small, so I only use it in special occasions, but I think I maybe should use it now. And it works to have, like, without makeup. But yeah, I still really like this. I just wished it was a bigger bottle and it was a little bit more affordable. So yeah, still really, really like this. Then I talked about two lipsticks. And both of these are still some of my absolute favorite lipsticks ever. We can start with one that has been a favorite for a really long time, and it is the Soft Spoken Liquid Suede from NYX. And this is so old, but even though it shouldn't be good anymore, it still is the same formula and it still smells okay, so I still use it. And I really, really like this. I don't use it that much on camera, but off camera or outside of YouTube, I use this quite a lot. So this I still really like. And I really like the liquid suede formula. I think it's really, really good. And if you want to go into matte liquid lipsticks, I can really recommend liquid suedes from NYX. And the other lipstick favorite that I think I said about this, that I was a little bit afraid of using it when I first got it, and now I am not afraid of using it at all, and it is Unicorn Blood from Jeffree Star. If I would have get paid every time I named this shade from Jeffree Star, I would have a lot more money than I have now. I talk about this a lot. It feels like this is one of my absolute favorite lipsticks of all times. This is perfect. I love how it looks at me, on me, at me. I love how you look at me. I love how it looks on me, and I get compliments pretty often, and I think it's really, really suits me. And yes, you are allowed to say that about yourself. It's just an amazing lipstick, and I can leave some videos up here where I have used it, but I have used it in a lot of videos. If I'm doing a dark green eye, this is normally what I use because I love it so much. I think this may be the first liquid lipstick that I will ever run out of, because Unicorn Blood, I love you so much. So, so much. Okay, so it really feels like I'm speeding through this, and I think I do. I have two more things to talk about. One thing that I can show you and the other I can't. I said in a year ago, or not a year ago, but yeah, in my March favorite, that I have found what I thought was my new favorite mascara, and I still think it is. And I talked about NYX Worth the Hype, and I still want that so bad. It's one of the best mascaras I have ever tried. I really, really, really loved it. And I was so sad when it was gone. I still love it. It is one of the best I have ever tried. Yeah. I don't have it anymore because it's empty. I have thrown it away. So, and the last one, I talked about an eyeshadow palette. And I still really love this palette. It's one of my favorites. It's one of my absolute favorites from Juvia's Place. And it is, of course, Cry Palette. This I love so much. It feels like I've talked about this a lot as well. It looks like this, if you didn't know. I love the more grungy tones. Like this one. I love the shimmers. And I just love this palette. I think it's perfect. I love green. I think I have to like say it now. I love green eyeshadows and I love orange, and this has both. And I have done some of my absolute favorite looks with this palette, and I still really love it. And it is at the top when it comes to my Juvia's Place palette. So yeah, I still really love it. And yeah, that was all for this throwback favorites from March 2019. I, as I said, really like to do these videos, but it feels too much to do them every month. So I think I will do it when I have, like now, I found some of my absolute favorite products last year in March. So I thought it was going to be fun to do this again and see if I still love those products. Blah, blah, blah. And yes, I do. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so don't miss any of my videos. And I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!